Hello and welcome to HormoneNurse.com. Today we're going to talk about something that a lot of people get squeamish around. They don't want to hear about it, but it is of real life. We're going to learn today about how to do an enema. There's a lot of different enemas than just water enemas. There are several different reasons that people do enemas. There's several different kinds of enemas. There is an enema because people are constipated and haven't had a bowel movement for 3 or 4 days. So that is going to be usually the warm water enema. They can also put a little bit of glycerin soap in there, and that is called a lemon glycerin soap suppository. That helps soften the stool and get it out. Another type of enema is for your health. They can be coffee enemas or calamine tea enema. And those are healthy enemas that just will help clean out your gallbladder or just help you relax. And then there's people that might be on the HCG protocol and they are taking 500 calories in. And anybody that eats very little, like 500 calorie diet, you're not going to have a lot of waste to come out. And so you might need a little bit of help with an enema. Now your enema bag, we'll take the red rubber one, is the one we're going to talk about today. It comes in 2 different pieces. This is the bladder, and you're going to fill it up with whatever you want to fill it up with. If you're going to be using water or any kind of liquid, you want it to be nice and warm. You don't want it to be hot so that it doesn't burn you, and you don't want it to be really cold because that could lower your body temperature too much. So you fill it up about 3/4 full. You'll feel the bladder expanding, and so you'll know that it's about 3/4 full. Then you take your tube, and this is what stops the water from coming out of the bag. And this is your tube here. Now this is the nozzle. You do not want to put a dry nozzle up inside you because you might have hemorrhoids, or it just will be uncomfortable. You might be really tight and you might tear something. So we don't want any damage to be done. This is supposedly a good thing to do. So you want to take KY lubricant jelly. You can get it out of a big bottle. You can get it out of little packages. But what you want to make sure that whatever you put on here, it is water soluble. That means that it is going to evaporate once it's in your body and cause no harmful effect to you. So you want to make sure that it is a water soluble lubricant. You stick it on there, you get it all very, very lubricated. Now you're going to want to lay down on your back with your knees up, or you can lay on your side on a fetal position. If you're going to choose a fetal position, pull one leg, your outside leg, up a little bit higher. And that gives the muscles the chance to relax and open up. You're going to want to put this nozzle all the way in. Now your bag is going to be hanging on a door somewhere where you don't have to hold it up because it's going to get very tiring. So you want to hang it on somewhere where it has gravity to go down into you. Once the nozzle is inside of you and the bag is hanging up, then it is safe to unlatch and let the water come in. Now make sure that when you take this nozzle out, even if you don't think there's water left in there, make sure that you close your nozzle. Because if you don't and there's still water coming out, it could spray all over your bathroom, all over you, and it just makes for a traumatic time. And don't worry if that happens to you, because I've seen it happen. So have good luck with your enema, and if you have any questions, just log on to www.hormonenurse.com or call me, the Hormone Nurse, at 602-348-3686.